Hello, class. A number of years ago, I did an arrangement of Jimmy Webb's great song, MacArthur Park. I pretty much took the arrangement from his more recent version with Brian Wilson, and I think the album was titled Still in My Own Voice or something like that. Wonderful rendition of MacArthur Park. I recommend it highly. But the chord structure I pretty much copped from that arrangement, and I did lower the key so I'm able to sing it. I think maybe that it was three half steps higher. Maybe it was in C minor rather than B minor. I think it was in D minor rather than B minor. But I've lowered it down to accommodate my extremely limited vocal range. So I'm going to show you the chords as we go, and I'll describe those, but I will also try to add the melodies in where I'm able and show you how to do those if you want to incorporate those too. But if you want to just strum the chords and sing along, you're able to do that too. So there are a lot of chords in this one, so hold on to your hats. Here we go. So it starts on this B minor. And then you're going to walk down the bass. So I'm just playing the E minor. I'm not playing the B, because I'm going to play the melody with my fingers up here, so I don't want to tie up my index finger down there. But the opening chords are B minor, B minor with A in the bass, so now I'm playing the A string open, C chord with a G in the bass, E minor over D note. So when I'm playing that, I can't go lower than the E string. It'd be nice if I could. So we have to hit the D string open to go down to a D note. So I'm just playing the D string, G string, and B string open, which is my E minor over a D note. And then we get into those bizarre chords coming back up. All right, now if you want to add the melody in there. All right, so we're playing that, sliding the index finger up. So those are the melody, that's the melody above the chord. So you play that B minor with the A in the bass, same melody up top. You go to the C with the G in the bass, and that's the melody coming down, open E string, B string, going to the E minor chord. So, the weird connection there. This is pretty close to what he does on the piano. It's not exactly, but it's much easier to do than what he's actually doing on the piano. So this is what I recommend. Play F, so this would be the bottom part of F chord, except we have the C in the bass there. So I'm really playing only those three strings, the A string, D string, and G string of the F chord. And then I'm lifting my fingers off to play this G over C. So it's. Then I strum that again, and I fret the F chord again, except you can kind of hear my melody is working its way up because I'm only playing the low strings. And now we're coming up. Now we have the B string sounding out as well. And then we go to this B flat with a C in the bass to a C with a D in the bass. So just barring your finger all the way across. Stayed one step ahead as we followed in the dance. In the party papers, and I can't remember all the lyrics, so I'm gonna be butchering the lyrics somewhat because I don't have them in front of me here. And the birds like tender babies in your hands, and the old man playing checkers by the trees. So yeah, it repeats the verse, you know, four times, and then when it gets to the chorus, you play an F chord, G chord, and modulate up to A major. MacArthur Park is melting in the dark. A major 7. All the sweet green icing flowing down. So now we got this G with an A in the bass. Someone going to D major. Someone left the cake out in the rain. D major 7. And I don't think that I can take it. We got this F sharp minor, because it took so long to bake it. Now we got an A chord with an E in the bass. And I'll never have. So now we're going to this B9 chord. Never have that recipe again. Now we have this D minor with a major 7. A lot of dissonance there, right? That I can take it, cause it took so long to bake it, and I'll never have that recipe again. Now we're going to an A over E note. Oh no. Now we've got D. So it starts off with A over E. Now we have D over E. And then we pause there before going to a C chord. And that's our melody. Same thing over an A minor 7 chord. All right, now we go to an E flat major, so it's just like a D major chord slipped up one fret, and you're going to play that melody on the upper E string. Come down and play those notes on the G, B string, and then we're going to play this G with the third in the bass. Play that melody on the upper E to an A7, dominant 7 chord. So that whole section sounds like. So what we're doing there is we're starting on a D major, going to a D major 7, and then we're playing really a C major or a G major 7 over D. And then adding those melodies on the B string and E string. And then we're we're going to a G minor 6 with a D in the bass. There will be room for me. Someone will bring it. And then we're back to the D major. There will be another song for me. For I will sing it. There will be another moon for me. Someone will bring it. And then we go to this E minor 7. A D with a third in the bass. Walking up to a G major 7 chord.
I will drink the wine while it is warm.
Now we're playing an A, so I'm barring an A, but I'm keeping the G in the bass.
Getting at the sun.
And then we're going to be going to an F sharp minor 7, and then a B7 suspended 4. All right, so.
I will drink the wine while it is warm. Never let them catch me looking at the sun. After all the loves of my life.
All right, so now we're playing, what I'm doing is really playing a G over an open E string, which is a E, you know, minor 7 chord.
After all the loves of my life.
So now I move the bass string up to the open A string. So now I have G over A. And then I'm gonna make it briefly a G minor over A just by lifting my middle finger off the G string.
After all the loves of my life. After all,
then we go to a D major 7. So,
I will drink the wine while it is warm. Never let them catch me looking at the sun. After all the loves of my life. After all the loves of my life.
Okay, then we're going to a G major 7 chord.
I'll still be thinking, you'll still be the one.
So then we go to a C major 7 chord.
You'll still be the one.
All right, then we're going to this cool little turnaround here. I'm playing the E string on the 6th fret. I've got the D string open. I'm fretting the G string on the 5th fret and the B string on the 6th fret. And all the other strings are muted. And now I just have the D string and G string fretted here, and I'm letting the B string ring open. Really cool turnaround.
I will take my life.
That takes us back to the D.
Into my hands, and I will use it. I will win the worship in their eyes, and I will lose it. I will have the things that I desire, and my passion flows like rivers through the sky. After all the loves of my life. After all the loves of my life, I'll still be thinking of you.
and wandering. So now we've gone to this F sharp, 7 suspended 4, and then resolving it just to the F sharp 7. Why? So all we've done there is we've repeated the intro just at a slightly faster tempo. Say, we're going up 2 more frets. We're coming up those. And we come up to the D over the E note. And then we're going into that vamp, the instrumental vamp, and you can do whatever you want to on this, but it's a very common vamp back in the day. To over E minor, you would play E minor, A over E, B minor over E, and back to the A, back to the E minor. So it's a very common vamp back in the day. Do the same thing in B minor, except this time we're going from B minor, C sharp minor, to D, back to C sharp minor. So there we're just going, we're playing a G chord over C note, and we're playing an F sharp minor 7 chord, whatever you want to in that section. But here's how they get back to the chorus from here. It's quite a journey back to the chorus, but it's so cool. So he goes to this C again with the third, with the fifth in the bass, with the G in the bass. And he plays that melody on top. And then he's going to an E chord with the third in the bass and playing that same melody on top. So I have to finger it like this. E string here, D string open, G string here, B string there. Going to an A minor chord, and that's the melody we're picking on top of the A minor chord. Going to a D minor, playing the same sequence of notes or the same motif. Thank you. so here starts a pretty incredible sequence of chords back to the chorus, back to the main chorus. So, you know, we're coming out of all that. All right, we're actually playing this kind of out of an E flat chord, but I'm playing the A string here, the D string here. And then I go to a G chord. I'm just kind of following that sort of motif right up the scale. And then back to A major for the chorus. So let me kind of play that so that you can hear what it sounds like.
MacArthur Park is melting in the dark. All the sweet green I sing flowing down. Someone left the cake out in the rain. And I don't think that I can take it, 'cause it took so long to bake it, and I'll never have that recipe again. A minor 7. No.
And then on the record, they go to this B flat chord. And what I'm doing is borrowing some harmony out of it. It sounds really powerful on the record if you listen to it. Very powerful. But I'm borrowing these notes out of the B flat. And then going to a G over D, and then back to a D, and back to the G over D, and finishing on the D chord. So let me let you hear what that all sounds like.
MacArthur Park is melting in the dark. All the sweet green I sing flowing down. Someone left the cake out in the rain. And I don't think that I could take it, 'cause it took so long to bake it, and I'll never have that recipe again. Oh no.
And that brings us to the end. What a journey. Lots of chords. I hope you can find some of that useful.